Hey guys, welcome back to my blog Market Analysis with MeghModi.com and my YouTube channel. Well, yesterday market has given some excellent movement. Now if you say that 5% up move by any index, you know, is something which is, you know, very hard to see. You know, you see this kind of movement in possibly when there is a major event coming in, or there is some kind of like an election or something like that, or you know, some kind of announcement by the government. So this has actually happened, where you know, the finance minister has come in and has given some, you know, some corporate rate cuts, which has boosted the which has actually possibly, you know, given a great picture to the Indian economy, which has actually made prices go up. Now this is something which you know, people need to understand, that prices were supposedly to go up, however there was no price confirmation. So in my previous videos of Nifty, I have been, you know, placing a lot of moving averages and trend lines to make you understand that this is the, you know, a resistance zone. Once it crosses this resistance zone, prices are supposedly to go up, and that is exactly what has happened. Now yes, I would like to show you my view counts here. So my wave counts are like simple. This is A, this is up going B, then this is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, this is C. So one leg of ABC has been over and prices now are, you know, bound to go up. Now the overall sentiment has now turned positive and there is absolutely no worries that market will further tumble. Lot of small oscillators and you know, indicators on, you know, smaller time frame, on bigger time frame, has shown good reversals. So I thoroughly feel that prices now are going up now, and there is, you know, no way that this price will now break 10,600. So 10,600 will be my important support, and once that breaks, it can go till 10,000, which is a multiple support. So I don't think now that 10,600 will be broken. I feel that we are now heading back to somewhere around 12,000 odd mark. So here is the the chart, and where I have shown a triangle pattern, and prices have surpassed the resistance line and has gone up. Now this is something which is a very strong candle on weekly charts as well, on daily charts as well, and on hourly chart, which is in front of you. So here I have kept my wave counts very simple. I have not gone further into my neo wave count, which has been terminated as wave E has gone, is almost equal to wave C. So I have not given that count, and I have, you know, taken out and shown a symmetrical triangle pattern, and based on that I have given you the snapshot of it. Now the last leg, which is wave 5, is a termination, which means that once it is terminated, prices, that it, that means it doesn't go below wave 3 and fails to move below wave 3, prices will reverse faster, and that is what exactly has happened. That reversal, that fast reversal, is something which normally people don't see, but this actually happens post, after wave 5 is being terminated or truncated, and once truncation happens, the post effect is very dynamic, and that is what actually happened on Friday. So I have been also writing on my Twitter handle, which is @MeghModi, that a weekly close was very important. I remember many intraday and day traders were shorting the market, but when this has happened, they have faced a lot of losses, and which is very evident because I have been seeing a lot of posts that people were continuously saying that prices are going down and it will go down, it will break 10,600. It was not that simple. I was not bearish in all my videos and all my blog writing. I have been saying that continuously that market will not move below 10,600, and if it does, then it can tumble near to 10,000 odd levels. But somewhere down the line, I felt it will not go down, and I was like very much sure that it will break 11,105. So I was bullish, but there was no price confirmation, which has been obtained on Friday. So my buying levels were above 11,105. So once that triggered, market rallied till 11,180, 11,200 levels. That was my target, but it rallied further to 11,370 odd levels. So this is how you analyze, this is how you, analyze your trade setups very, very, very objectively. And, Elliott Wave and Neo Wave helps you to come out with an objective trade setups so that you can understand what is going to happen. Intraday players will always lose money because they just want to make money. They make 5 rupees and they lose 100 rupees. That is how they trade. But an Elliott Wave and Neo Wave practitioner or a trader will definitely look for trade setups. And that is the reason why they are very successful. So here in this case, I would like to say that I teach Elliott Wave and Neo Wave. If any one of you is interested to learn Elliott Wave and Neo Wave, you can definitely mail me. My mail address is meghmodi@gmail.com. You can read this in my blog as well. So if you have any inquiries about the learning perspective, you can definitely call me or mail me. My mail address is meghmodi@gmail.com. That is all from my side. Thank you so much.